What is KNIME Server REST API and what is it good for? Imagine you've trained a model to predict the sentiment of a text and you want to deploy it as a service now so that other applications, for example a website or mobile app, can send some text to your KNIME Server and get back the predicted sentiment. Or generally speaking, you want to integrate the results of a workflow into your own application. This video explains how to build a workflow that can be deployed to KNIME Server and called via the REST API using either another application or KNIME Analytics Platform itself. Let's assume you have a workflow that predicts the sentiment of airline reviews. At the moment, your analysis is carried out on a scheduled basis by reading from a database using this deployment workflow. The workflow reads new samples from a database, does some pre-processing, applies the trained gradient-boosted trees model to predict the sentiment, and then, after some post-processing, writes the sentiment prediction to the database. What we want to do now is change this workflow into a workflow that can be executed via REST as an on-demand prediction for an external application. KNIME has a variety of input nodes that can be used to define the REST API depending on your needs. You'll find these nodes under Workflow Abstraction, Workflow Invocation. Here, we want to use the Container Input Table node, as we want to predict multiple rows with a single call. The node has an optional input port, which allows you to use a template table to define the input structure. In the lower part of the Container Input Nodes dialog, you can see the template table and choose between using the entire input table as a template, restricting it to the first few rows, or omitting table spec in the API definition. This template serves two purposes. First, if no input table is provided when the workflow is called via the REST API, the values from the template are used by default for executing the workflow. Second, the table is used to define the format that the web service expects. If the format differs, the web service will send an error message. The advantage of this template technique is that the input is passed automatically and converted into the specified types. What would our prediction be without any output after executing the workflow? In our example, this means we want to send back the predicted sentiment of the different reviews. This can be handled by one of the container output nodes. As the output is expected to be a table with multiple rows of predictions, we chose the Container Output Table node here, as it outputs the entire table, i.e. all predictions, rather than just a single row or a single prediction. To make the service available, we have to deploy the workflow to KNIME Server. To be able to call your deployed workflow from your own application, you have to know the structure of the defined REST API and the expected input of the workflow. KNIME Server can show you the API definition in your browser. Simply right-click the deployed workflow and select Show API Definition. A browser window opens showing the REST API definition for this specific workflow. The web page you can see now is created using an open source framework called Swagger. Swagger has been integrated in KNIME Server to document the REST API in a way that allows you to easily explore the different HTTP requests and test them. In this case, we're interested in execution with a POST request. Here we have an overview of the execution path, the query parameters, and the request body via these two tabs. The Example tab shows you an input that can be used, and the Schema tab defines what the input should be like and what is expected. Here, the input schema consists of a table spec, which defines the columns we provide, their types, and in which order they occur. This is followed by the table data, which contains the actual input data. Below, we see the possible responses. By hitting the Try It Out button, you can define query parameters and input on the fly, and send a POST request by clicking Execute. This then shows the used curl command, the request URL, and the response that is returned by the server. You can also trigger execution of the service from KNIME Analytics Platform with the Call Workflow table-based node. This node allows us to call local or remote workflows with the provided input table, and it outputs the output of the called workflow. As we want to run a workflow on KNIME Server, we have to ensure that the Call Workflow node is connected to the server. We connect it with the KNIME Server Connection node. In the Configuration dialog, we have to provide the address to the server either by entering it manually or selecting a mount point and entering our credentials. Now that we've connected the call workflow nodes to KNIME Server, we can open its dialog. By clicking the Browse Workflows button, we get a list of all the workflows that are deployed to KNIME Server. Let's select our deployment workflow from the list, as our workflow is expected to have a short runtime and we want to reduce communication overhead to KNIME Server, we select the Short Duration option. In the Advanced settings, we can assign the input table to the input of the called workflow and the output table to the output of the called workflow. This feature comes in very handy when the deployed workflow has several different input nodes. Now we can execute the call workflow node, which uses the REST API of our deployed workflow to execute it and receives the predictions. To summarise, the KNIME Server REST API offers an interface for non-KNIME applications to communicate with KNIME Server via simple HTTP requests. The main benefit of this kind of RESTful web service is that it's easy to use and integrate into your own application, giving you the computational power of your KNIME Server. KNIME Server automatically generates the REST API of your deployed workflows, making it available to all users of KNIME Server. This allows you to seamlessly deploy KNIME workflows as web services via REST API and integrate them into your data science infrastructure. This video showed you how to adjust your workflows so that they can be deployed as a web service via KNIME Server. Furthermore, it showed you where you can obtain all the necessary information you need for your external application to run, access, and use the deployed workflow.